Welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today under the topic probability, let us see what exactly we have in the question. Now moving on to the question, it is given that suppose we throw a die once, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? What is the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4? Now let us see how we can solve this question. Moving ahead to solution. So guys, as per this question, it is like given like suppose that we throw a die once, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? What is the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4? Okay, now let's see. So before moving, let us put the question like let x be the event of getting, let x be the event, be the event, let x be the event of getting a number greater than 4, getting a number greater than 4. Okay, similarly let y be the event of getting a number, so let y be the event of getting a number less than or equal to 4, number less than or equal to 4. Okay, now whatever is given, just I have taken, tried to take two events, naming x as one event and y as another event, where x is the event where getting a number is greater than 4 and y is the event where getting a number less than or equal to 4. Guys, let us first of all imagine one die or dice, whatever it may be. So if you look at a die or dice, there are six sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then we have 6. Okay, so guys, if you look here, a dice is having 6 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, what exactly the question is asking us? The question is asking us or trying to ask us like, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? Now, if you look here it is up to 4. Greater than 4 means there are only two numbers, 5 or 6. So guys, here you could see that there are only three numbers greater than, there are only two numbers greater than 4, either it is 5 or 6. So guys, what we can write here, number of favorable outcomes here is 2, because either we could get 5 or 6, which is greater than 4. Similarly, if you look to the other side of the question, where it is asking us, what is the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4? See, less than or equal to 4, it starts from here till here. So number of favorable outcomes here is 4, because it is less than or equal to 4. So that means it starts from 1 and ends with 4. Altogether, there are 4 outcomes. Number of favorable outcomes will be 4 in this case. Now, let us see what exactly we are going to do. Like, probability of an event is represented by number of favorable events, number of favorable events upon total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes. Okay, so guys, in a case of dice, the total number of outcomes is 6, because there are 6 sides of a dice, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Now number of favorable events, now if we look to the first part of the question, is like, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? So we have considered, let x be the event of getting a number greater than 4. So I can write px is equal to, number of favorable events in this case, getting a number greater than 4 is 2. So number of favorable events here is 2. Total number of outcomes here is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because it's a dice, or that is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, Px is equal to, we got 1 by 3. This is our first part of the question. Now, let us look to the second part. Second part of the question, getting a number less than or equal to 4. So we have considered y is the event, getting a number less than or equal to 4. So Py is equal to number of favorable events. So number of favorable events here is 4. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, which is either equal or less than 4, upon total number of outcome is 6. Or that is equal to 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Therefore, Py is equal to 2 by 3. So that's all, guys. These are the two answers that we got. One is 1 by 3 and the other one is 2 by 3. So we can say that what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? We can say that the probability of getting a number greater than 4 is 1 by 3. And the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4 is 2 by 3. Hope, guys, you understood this calculation or this process. This is very simple and very easy. Just you need to understand the question and represent the question in the paper so that you can easily get a direction to move ahead. Guys, if you still have any questions or doubts, please reach out to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely, I will get back to you once I see your comments. Guys, if you really like my videos, please subscribe. If you really like my videos, I would request you to kindly subscribe and also let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.